Hi friends, today we are going to see how to solve a problem using DIT FFT flow graph. So let us say that the given x of n is -1, 0, 2, 0, -4, 0, 2, 0. This is my given x of n, and they are asking me to find x of k. So x of k has been asked and x of n has been given to me. Now the first step that you have to do is just draw 8 parallel lines. Okay, now the first we will first jot down how x of n will look like, and we will jot down what x of k will look like. So x of n is divided as even and odd part, and further the even and odd are combined together to give further even and odd subsamples. So we get the resultant as x of 0 and x of 4 sample together. Then we have x of 2 and x of 6 together. Then we have x of 1 and x of 5 together. And we have x of 3 and x of 7 together. Okay, so how I have placed 0, 4, 2, 6, 1, 5, 3, 7. This should be the order in 8-point DIT FFT. Now, which is, let us say, where is the value of n is equal to 0? This is n is equal to 0, n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3, n is equal to 4, 5, 6, 7. So what is n is equal to 0? N is equal to 0 is minus 1. N is equal to 4, its value is minus 4. N is equal to 2, it's 2. N is equal to 6, it's also 2. N is equal to 1, which is 0. N is equal to 5, which is also 0. So x of 5 is from here is 0, x of 3 is 0, and x of 7 is also 0. So we got a very unique problem wherein all the odd components are 0 in the given problem, but this might not happen every time. Now the first stage is to connect two lines together. So let us connect two lines together. So first crisscross only between two lines, right? And second line, I have to put a minus one. So I'll put all second lines minus one. Agreed. Now let us add. Whenever two lines meet, we have to do addition. So here it meets together. So let us do the addition. So minus one, minus four, added together gives me minus 5. So this is minus 5. Then minus 1, minus of minus plus. So it will be plus 4 minus 1 will give me plus 3. Then 2 plus 2 will give me 4. Whereas 2 minus 2 will give me 0. 0 plus 0 will give me 0. 0 minus 0 is also 0. Here is the same case. This is the end of first stage. Now let us go ahead. Now we will have multipliers, and now before multiplier we will now use four lines. So the first line will get combined with the third line, the second line will get combined with the fourth line. In the same way, first line combining with the third line and second line combining with the fourth line. Now we will put 2 minus 1 on the last two lines. Here also the same case, first line to third line, second line to fourth line, first line to third line, second line to fourth, minus 1 minus 1. Okay, now we have multipliers over here, before here, in between, as W8 raised to w 8 raised to 0 and w 8 raised to 2. Similar way, on the bottom two lines, w 8 raised to 0, w 8 raised to 2. Okay, now from this circle, you can see w 8 raised to 0 is 1. So I'll write it is equal to 1. And w 8 raised to 2 is minus j. So I'll write here as minus j. Okay, in the same way, w 8 raised to 0 is 1, w 8 raised to 2 is minus j. Agreed? So this is what my flow graph looks like till the second stage. Now let us bring our samples ahead. Minus 5 does not have any multiplier, so it will be minus 5 as it is. 3 will come here, 3. 4 will be multiplied by 1, it will be 4. Minus j multiplied by 0 is 0 back. 0 multiplied by nothing, 0. 0 multiplied by anything is 0. You're also 0. You're also 0. Agreed? Now, let us proceed for the last stage. Okay, the last stage, we have the first line going to meet the fifth line. So I'm going to make a cross line till the fifth line. Okay, the second line is going to meet the sixth line. The third line going to meet seventh line, and the fourth line is going to meet the eighth line. Similarly, we will have the first line going back to the fifth line, the second line going to the sixth line, the third line going back to seventh line, and the last line combining over here. Okay, so now we are combined all of the lines. Now we will put minus 1 on the last line. So minus 1 comes here, then minus 1 comes here, minus 1, minus 1. So I'll put 4 minus 1s on the last 4 lines. Okay, now here we have multipliers. So what are the multipliers? Let us put with the red mark the multiplier. The multiplier stop over here is 8 raised to 0. Here it is 8 raised to 1. Here it is w 8 raised to 2. And here it is w 8 raised to 3. Okay, now minus 5 plus 4. When I am combining two lines, it will come as minus 5, and here I am getting plus 4. Minus 5 plus 4 minus 1. 3 plus 0 is 3. Minus 5 minus 4 minus 9. 3 plus 3 minus 0 is 3 back. Okay, here 0, 0, 0. So all terms will be 0 back here. Okay, now whenever we are going to proceed further, then I will bring the samples ahead. When I'm bringing the samples ahead, minus 1 comes here, minus 1, 3 comes here as 3, this comes as minus 9, and this comes as 3 back. Now all the multipliers over here is multiplied by 0. So I'm going to get 0, 0, 0, 0. But let us check what are the values that will come over this point. W8 raised to 0 is 1. And W8 raised to 2 is minus j that we have just seen. W8 raised to 1 is what? 0.707 minus j 0.707. So it's a huge value. It's 0.707 minus j 0.707. And w8 raised to 3 is minus 0.707 minus j 0.707. So we will put these two complex numbers over here and we will multiply with the respective numbers. Now it is being multiplied by 0, hence this values does not mean anything to me. Next, let us combine them. 1 added with 0 is minus 1 added with 0 will give me minus 1. 3 added with 0 will give me 3. Minus 9 added with 0, minus 9. 3 added with 0 will give me 3. Minus 1 subtracted with 0 is minus 1. 3 subtracted with 0 is 3. Minus 9 subtracted with 0 is minus 9. And 3 subtracted with 0 is 3. Okay, so now what is my x of 0? This is my x of capital X of 0. This is capital X of 1. This is capital X of 2. This becomes capital X of 3. This is my capital X of 4. This is my capital X of 5. This is capital X of 6. And this is capital X of 7. So this is what the required answer of DFT from X of 0 to X of 7. So in DIT FFT flow graph, we see that whenever I write X of K, I'll write in order. But whenever I write X of N, they will not be in order. They will be in shuffled order. And shuffling order is fixed. So you should first write X of 0, then X of 4, then X of 2, then X of 6 for the even part. In the odd part, we'll write X of 1, then X of 5, then X of 3, and then X of 7. This way, the flow graph occurs and gives you the correct result. Thank you.